Hi, this is Larry Jordan. The following is an excerpt of a recent PowerUp webinar taking a look at new features inside Final Cut Pro 10 version 10.1. In this excerpt, we look at the new interface. This is the new interface for Final Cut Pro 10, and it looks very, very similar to the old interface. But there's some small things that have changed throughout the application. The most obvious is down here in the low left corner. We're no longer able to click on the project library. That whole command zero is gone. Projects are now available to us up here in the browser. This used to be called events. It's now called libraries. And if I grab this vertical line that separates the two, give ourselves some room to work, notice that I have events inside the library. The library is the collection of everything associated: projects, clips, media, events, everything. Then each of these individual folders is an event folder. In this particular case, I decided to put projects both in the event itself and in the projects folder. Now, you can store projects wherever you want inside the library. Everything gets stored inside an event. Again, think of it as a containing folder for stuff. But the library itself is listed on the left-hand side. Notice also that hard disks are no longer listed, and that's because libraries can be stored anywhere. You could store a library on a thumb drive, a sparse image, optical media, as well as a RAID or a hard disk. Keep in mind that if you were to store it to a DVD or store it to a thumb drive, you'd be able to store it there, but it wouldn't have the performance you need to be able to play stuff back. Libraries can be stored anywhere that you can mount to the desktop and named any file name that you want to give it. So that whole Final Cut Events, Final Cut Projects folder structure that we had to work with is now gone. Well, if we look over here inside the viewer, a couple of other really cool features. Notice that this is our typical two-viewer display. If I go up to the window menu, I can say hide the libraries, and notice the library display is gone. This gives me more ability, more room to see clips. We could turn it on and off with this button down here. But what's new is when I go back to the window menu, I can also hide the browser. This allows me to see just the viewer. And if I click on the inspector, I've got room for the inspector, and I could also display scopes. I can make the clips disappear to give myself room to see scopes and to see the image and to see the inspector. Much, much more helpful when I'm done doing all of my editing clips down to the timeline and now I want to do color grading or I want to do effects or I want to do trimming. Being able to have the browser be bigger makes a big difference. Again, we'll just hide scopes. Command 4 to hide the inspector. Keyboard shortcut for scopes, by the way, is Command 7. And we can increase or decrease the size allowed for the browser by grabbing this horizontal line and dragging up or down. And as we had with the earlier version, we could display it to a second monitor if we had, there it is, if we had a second display attached to our computer. Another thing that's worth noting, let's put our browser back here, show the browser, and show libraries, go down to here. In the past, we would set optimized or proxy files using a preference setting, and we would change the performance versus quality also as a preference. Those have now moved to this switch in the top right corner of the viewer. Better quality gives us a pixel-for-pixel accurate display of the image, but requires more CPU horsepower. Better performance scales the pixels that are being displayed, makes text look a little moth-eaten, but it's giving us much faster playback with less rendering. Whatever of these two we choose, our output will always be the highest quality. This affects playback during editing only. And this is how we're able to select whether we want to display proxy files, which I have not created for this project, or optimized or camera native files. Both of these settings for quality and media used to be a preference setting. They're now moved to a switch inside the viewer. This has been an excerpt of a recent PowerUp webinar taking a look at the new features inside Final Cut Pro 10 version 10.1. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store and look for Webinar 115. And thinking of training, if you need to stretch your training dollars, a subscription membership to our video training library saves you money. You can access all of our videos for a low monthly price of only $19.99. That's more than 700 movies, dozens of hours of training, all in-depth and up-to-date. Plus, members can attend any of our PowerUp webinars for free. Our training covers both Apple and Adobe software. We update it every week. And for more information, visit larryjordan.biz/subscriptions. And thanks.